why the Dawah channels, yeah, when they don't appreciate, they just cast people. That's what they do. Go there. That's what they do. They just love to cast people.
Where? Are you talking about the comments or the channel itself?
Well, if you talking,
yeah,
I'll be happy if you ask, can I record? Not just random.
It's a public place, it's fine.
Well, it's a public place, but you stop people to ask them, can we talk? So
it's not necessary. If you think it's better, that's fine, but it's not necessary, is it?
I just want to ask you. The point is, I asked you a simple question. You still haven't answered my question?
No, let me just explain something to you. Paddy, are you with me?
I'm listening.
Okay. There's a thing where... Alhamdulillah. There's a thing where a person, he asks a question. And a person gives an answer. If you're not happy with the answer, that's fine. We can continue the conversation. But you can't say the question hasn't been answered. Because I'm telling you that the message which Jesus came with is the same message which came with, and the same message which Muhammad came with, peace be upon all of them, that God is one and worship Him alone without any partners. That's the message of all the messengers. But I don't believe that you, as a Christian, you've understood the concept of the oneness of God.
You see,
because of the Trinity.
Are you telling me, Jesus, when? The only thing Jesus was doing is he's going everywhere telling God is one. Is that the only message he came to preach?
No. No.
So that's why I asked you.
But,
that's why I asked
but,
you.
But, what that, is the but, that is, but that is the foundation which everything
no,
is built
we
upon.
We don't have a problem. Uh-huh. Nobody has a problem. Uh-huh. The point is, what is the gospel? The gospel has a meaning. What is that meaning?
Okay. You explain from your side.
How many do you know or not? Because the gospel is like when you read the Quran, because the Quran clearly tells us the Torah, it makes distinction of the Torah, the Injil,
yes,
and the Zabur, and the Quran.
Yes, the distinction.
Which is the revelations that Allah revealed.
Gave to each prophet, according to Islam, yes.
Right,
yes.
But then, Islam teaches.
Yeah, yes.
But then the gospel,
yeah,
they said the Injil,
yeah.
The Injil is a Greek word anyway. In terms of when you translate it into English, it means the good news.
Yes.
But that good news,
yes,
it has a meaning.
Okay.
And the meaning means average person wants to know, because at the end of the day, I've always said this, the books is been given to people for us to understand.
Yeah.
So if we don't understand the books, then we have to throw all the books somewhere. But the books, there are meaning to it, the message of the books. So what is the meaning of the gospel?
Okay. Okay.
That's all I ask.
No
I'm
problem.
Not asking.
No problem. No problem. I'm going to answer you. When you talk about the Injil,
yes,
I'm going to tell you, according to the Quran, whether you accept it, whether you don't accept it, is a separate matter. The Quran is very clear. In Surah Ma'idah, chapter number 5, it mentions wa'ataynahu al-Injil, that we gave Jesus the Injil. Okay. In chapter 19 of the Quran, it mentions, "Qala inni abdullah atani al-kitab." Jesus said, "Verily, I am the worshipper of God, and I have been given a book." So for us, the Injil is what Jesus was given, the revelation at the time. It's not referring to 27 books of the New Testament written after Jesus, even though they may contain something from the essence of the message, but the message is not preserved. You don't have it.
See, that's interesting response. But you see what you just said? Very, very interesting.
I'm happy you're interested.
Very interesting response.
Uh-huh.
But that's okay.
Are you surprised by the response?
Because you see,
are you surprised by the response?
Okay. If you tell me, Jesus preached the same message, which is one God.
Yes.
Nobody has a problem with that. Because we know God is one. Because the
Trinity is not one.
No, I know you guys have problem with Trinity, but I'm not talking about Trinity right now.
But that
would take
and unity. You can't put them together. Yeah.
You see, the fact that you don't understand Trinity, the fact that you don't understand, it doesn't change anything.
It's not one.
What I'm saying is, the fact that you don't understand Trinity, it doesn't change the Trinity. Because you see, every one of us.
And Paddy, the same way, if you continue saying that as a Christian, I believe in one God. As a Christian, I believe in one God. Even if you say that, and even if you believe it, once you believe in the Trinity, then this is not the concept of the oneness of God which the messengers came with.
What me say? I mean, have you taken time to read the full Bible?
Yeah, many years ago.
Well, but you see, when you take time to read the scriptures, the Trinity, the Trinity is a terminology that describes the plurality of God.
Sorry, say that again. The Trinity is a
terminology that describes the plurality of God.
The priority.
Plurality.
Which means?
Plurality means, you see, in terms of God is one, but the same one God is the God the Father.
It's three separate persons.
No, it's not three separate separation. That's your understanding.
Oh, no. Many Christians, they will say that God is one in nature, but he's made up of three separate persons.
No, God is one. Uh-huh. Yeah. But if God is the God who is one, revere himself as Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit. And when you read the scripture, according to...
Is the Father fully God?
You see how quickly...
I'm asking.
You see how quickly we have shifted from the gospel into a different thing.
This is the most important thing.
I'm happy to talk about that. Yeah. But I want you, I see you as a scholar.
No, I'm not a scholar, definitely not.
I mean, it's amazing how all of you detach yourself from being scholar.
No, you know why? Shall I tell you why? Yeah. I tell you why. Islamically, people understand it differently. But generally, people, they would understand the scholar is someone who... Some Muslims will understand the scholar is someone who fulfilled a syllabus. Don't worry about it.
No, I'm saying.
Some
days I don't like.
Recording. Don't have but nothing to hide.
No, I know. I'm not saying. But some days.
But let me get the scholar point. Yeah. Some people, they would understand the scholar, someone who fulfilled a certain curriculum, a certain syllabus, and at the end they sat exams. Okay, so they will say this person has completed this course, they've sat this exams, they're competent, and they will pass, and they will be considered a scholar. That's how some people in the Muslim world consider a scholar. Other people would consider a scholar someone who sat with scholars and studied for multiple years until the point where the scholars, they said, this person, due to his level of knowledge, his ability, his understanding, we have given him the title scholar. So someone in Islam may have some kind of knowledge, he may be able to speak but we won't consider him a scholar.
Which of these ones that you sat underneath?
No, so I haven't fulfilled either of them. So that's why I say I'm not a scholar.
Well, but I can see a lot of your guys look up to you. I've seen them looking up to you.
Well, we respect each other, but it's still not a scholar. But that's neither here nor there.
Fine. But then I still get back to our initial conversation.
Yes.
Yeah. What the gospel... You know, because the angel obviously says when he says it's a good news according to
language,
good news. But what is the meaning of that good news?
Okay, that's your question. I'm going to tell you what I understand from the Quran and from the teachings of the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. You can accept it, you can reject it, your choice. For us, the Quran explains very clearly that Jesus was sent as a messenger to the children of Israel to call them back to the worship of the one true God alone, without any partners, without any equals. He never claimed to be God, and he never died for the sins of mankind, and he called them to obey God according to the laws of Moses. Some of the laws of Moses, how would you say? Then Jesus, he changed some of them by revelation. But that's the general message.
Jesus changed some of them by what? Revelation.
Let me find the verse. وَأَحِلَّ لَكُمْ بَعْضُ الَّذِي حُرِّمَ عَلَيْكُمْ He made some things which were not permissible for the Jews, he made it permissible for them. This is what the Quran mentions. But the point being, Jesus did not come as God or part of a Trinity. He did not claim to be the Son of God, and he did not die for the sins of mankind.
Are you talking from the Quran perspective, or are you talking from the Bible perspective?
I'll tell you what perspective I'm talking from. I'm talking from the perspective of the Quran. I'm talking from the perspective of reality and the truth.
So, but you see, your argument...
Sorry, how are you? Alhamdulillah.
You see, your argument, Jesus himself.
Yeah.
He himself.
Yeah.
I mean, it's good to give your personal understanding.
Oh, it's not my personal understanding. No, I mean, this is the Quran. Final revelation for mankind.
What I'm saying is, according to Jesus himself, he attested the Son of God. So,
where did he attest it?
It's all over the scripture. So
yeah, that's the point. Bible. But I don't believe the Bible is the word of God. That's the point.
You don't believe the Bible the word of God?
As I mentioned to you previously, the Quran clearly states that Jesus was given the Injil, okay? And he was given a book. We don't believe that the 27 books of the New Testament, which are attributed to a person called Mark, Matthew, Luke, and John, the 13 letters attributed to Paul, the epistles attributed to James and Peter, etc., 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 down to Revelation. We don't believe these are revelation given to Jesus. We believe they're books written after Jesus.
Let me make it clear. You don't believe the Bible is the word of God. Is that your position?
As a whole...
No, I just want to understand. Is that your position? The Bible is not the word of God, according to you.
I'll tell you. It's not just a simple yes or no.
You see how you're doing, pick and choose?
No.
Because you always quote the Bible. No. So if the Bible is not, why are you quoting the Bible for your argument?
Okay, now you ask one question. I didn't answer, now you ask the second question. Let me answer
because
the first question.
Let me make it clear. We spent 10 minutes.
Yeah.
You haven't answered a simple question I asked.
I answered them. Whether you like the answer or not, whether you agree, that's separate, but I answered them.
Very simple question. Okay. I'm trying to have a civil conversation. That's all I want.
We are being civil.
Yeah.
We're not insulting each other.
No.
We're not mocking each other.
I don't like that.
That's good. I agree with you.
I don't like that. Let him finish, please.
Let me So, the Bible. We believe in what was sent down to Moses, revelation. What was sent down to David, revelation. What was sent down to Jesus, revelation. We're saying that the Bible, whether you say 66 books or 73 books, they may contain some elements of the truth of revelation, but generally we don't know who wrote them, we don't know when they were written for majority of the books, and also they're mixed, they're not the revelation which was given. So I give you a very brief example. We believe that Moses was given the Torah, but what the Christians and Jews today call the Torah, the five books, Genesis, Exodus, Leviticus, Numbers, and Deuteronomy, we don't believe this is what Moses presented to his people.
It's fine. It's okay to say we don't believe it.
Yeah.
You see,
but it may contain some elements of truth.
When you say,
let me just clarify. Sorry. So, understand. I'm speaking as Yusuf, but this is how I understand that Muslims understand the Bible. From three points. From three angles. One is, if there's something in the Bible and it's confirmed by the Quran or the Sunnah, the authentic teachings of the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, we accept it.
That's very cherry picking, isn't it? Because you see what you mean.
Let me just finish the three things,
okay.
If you don't mind, and then I'll come back to your accusation.
No, because what you're saying is it's wonderful cherry picking games you're playing.
No.
The Bible, the section that it corresponds with the Quran.
Paddy, let me finish.
That's not. It's a very interesting statement you're making.
No problem. Let me finish, and then we'll discuss if it's cherry picking or not. Second point is, if there's something in the Bible which the Quran and the Sunnah, the authentic teachings of the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, reject, we reject it. Such as God having a son, such as Jesus dying for the sins of mankind, such as David committing adultery and murder, such as Lot committing incest, such as Noah becoming drunk and cursing his son Canaan, etc., etc. we reject this. Such as God resting on the seventh day, we reject this. Then thirdly, if there's something in the Bible which is neither affirmed or negated in the Quran, we stay back. Why we don't consider it cherry picking? If you want to consider it cherry picking, that's fine.
From what you just told, that's a cherry picking.
The Quran mentions, I believe, Surah 5, ayah, I think 48, if I'm not mistaken. It says, وَأَنْزَلْنَا عَلَيْكَ الْكِتَابَ بِالْحَقِّ مُصَدِّقًا لِمَا بَيْنَ يَدَيْهِ مِنَ الْكِتَابِ وَمُهَيْمِنًا عَلَيْهِ, that we have sent down to you a book in truth.
I'm listening.
No problem.
It's just that
We have sent down to you a book in truth, confirming the books which came before, and then it mentions Muhaymanun Alay. Muhaymanun Alay is the Quran is a judge over the previous books. So because we believe the previous books have been corrupted, the way you can know what is right and what is wrong is by the final revelation which has been preserved.
Okay. Let me come through. You said many things.
Yeah. Sorry, brother, if you don't mind.
You said many things.
Yes, Paddy.
You said the book is corrupt.
The Bible.
Yeah, according to what you just said. The book is corrupt.
Yeah.
Very interesting. Very, very interesting.
No problem.
The book is corrupt. The Bible is corrupt.
I'm not the first person to say it either.
According to your admission or submission, Allah who revered the book in terms of the Torah,
yes,
the Injil and the Zabur,
yes,
and the Quran, according to Islamic literature,
yeah,
he never said my revelation is corrupt. Allah never said that. You see, it's your claim. Allah who is with, as for you, you are only quoting the words of Allah. You understand? Yeah. But the Allah who is a reverer of these books never make that claim. So your words is contradicting the revelation of Allah. Because you see, when you go around telling that the book is corrupt, you understand? You haven't heard the average man or average woman who is seeking for truth to guide their life. You understand? I said from the beginning, the books, you know, the books, according to the books, the books is for, there's a message within the books for our learning. But now, you who did not revere the Torah, who did not revere the Injil and the Zabur, you are telling an average person who genuinely seeking the truth to guide their life, say it's corrupt. But that's not what Allah said.
Okay.
So that's why. So
let me know when you finish and I'll respond to you.
I've always said this. Yeah. Allah never made that claim.
Okay.
It's you are making that claim. According to the Quran,
the
Quran clearly established that in Surah 3, verse ayah 3, said the Quran came to confirm.
Yeah.
I mean, let me finish. Okay. I'm not an English scholar, but I understand one thing, confirmation.
Yes.
You understand?
Yes.
Confirm.
Yeah.
According to Surah 3, verse 3. According to Surah chapter 2, ayah 89, also confirm the previous. According to Surah chapter 2, verse 40 to 46, also establish the same thing. So you and Allah, who is telling the truth, you or Allah? Because Allah words that you are, and you are quoting from Allah's book. Allah never made that submission that my revelation that I reveal is corrupt. Allah never made that. As far as we have learned in the book of Allah, Allah never. But then, are you an imam or scholar? I mean, obviously you say you are not scholar.
No.
I believe you are imam.
No. Anyway, no.
What, but you hold a position?
No, I'm just a general Muslim.
Oh, come on. I know general Muslim when I talk to general Muslim.
Okay, Paddy.
Most of my friends are Muslim. When I talk to a general Muslim, you know what they said?
Yeah.
Oh, I'm not. They begin their. I'm not a scholar.
Who am I?
So
who am I not? That's a separate issue. But let me come to the point you mentioned.
Before we go here.
Let me respond to the point you made.
I gave you time to spoke.
No, no, but you made a number of points. No,
but because you see,
okay,
I have always said, please don't use the word corrupt in your, because you see, that statement is not helping the average young person
Okay.
who is seeking truth.
There's a number of points to respond to what you said. Okay. There's a number of points to respond to what you said. One is what Islam says about the previous revelations, what Allah says about the previous revelations, what the Quran says about the previous revelations. That's one point. Before we come to that, okay, biblical scholars will tell you that the books themselves are corrupt. Okay. Without names, I'll give you a very interesting example.
Now I'm telling you, which so before you, I know you are doing your research, which part of the Bible do you believe?
Okay, I just told you, I did tell you very clearly, anything which the Quran confirms, I believe.
Because it's a big book. Which one do you believe and which one do you, which oh. one? Yeah.
None of them holy. None of the 66 books, I believe, all of it is revelation. Whatever is mentioned there, and the Quran affirms it, I accept.
But the Quran is not the authoritative book over the Bible.
Well, according to the Quran,
that's
it is.
What you are. Yeah. You see, the Quran
Let me show you something. Paddy, you with me?
You are making. I like you already. I mean.
No problem. Let me show you something. Very interesting.
I'm rushing through and okay, let me show, have a good conversation.
Let me show you three verses from the Old Testament. If you want, if you're too busy, we can continue another time.
Yes, I like that.
This is Exodus chapter 6.
Okay.
Okay. And verse 2 and 3. Exodus 6, verse 2 and 3. And God spoke unto Moses and said unto him, I am the Lord. Okay, I'm going to say something now. I can prove it to you, but you can accept. But look, in the Old Testament, when you have Lord written L-O-R-D, all capitals, the Hebrew is, however people pronounce it, Yahweh, Jehovah. Do you agree or do you, I can get.
I'm listening.
But do you agree? Because I can get you the audio, but I don't. But your time is. So this word in Hebrew is Jehovah, however people choose to pronounce it. Okay. And then it mentions in the third verse, and I appeared unto Abraham, unto Isaac, and unto Jacob, by the name of God Almighty, but by my name Jehovah was I not known to them. Okay. So let me just paraphrase. Here in Exodus, God is telling Moses, that I've revealed to you my name, Jehovah. I spoke previously to Abraham, Isaac, and Jacob, but they never knew the name Jehovah. Huh?
I'm listening.
Okay. So, let's go back to Genesis and see. So this is Genesis chapter 13, verse 4. So Genesis 13, and maybe the listener doesn't know, but you know that Genesis comes before Exodus.
It's the third book in the Hebrew.
And Abraham, Isaac, and Jacob come before Moses.
It's the third book in the Hebrew.
Okay.
Yeah,
okay.
Agree, yeah.
So chapter 13, verse 4 mentioned, unto the place of the altar which he had made there at first, and there Abram called on the name of Jehovah. So Genesis chapter 13 verse 4 is saying that Abraham called unto the name Jehovah. Okay. Last one. When we go to Genesis chapter 14 verse 14. Oh, sorry, no. Chapter 14, Genesis 14, verse 22. And Abram said to the king of Sodom, I have lift up my hand unto the Lord, unto Jehovah, the Most High God, the possessor of the heaven and the earth. So, if you got the point, my point is, Exodus, it claims that God has told Moses that I'm revealing my name to you, Jehovah. I revealed myself, Almighty God, to Abraham, Isaac, and Jacob, but I never told them the name Jehovah. Okay. When you go back to the book of Genesis, Abraham used the name Jehovah and he knew the name Jehovah. So this is a clear contradiction. The way biblical scholars explain this is saying that these two stories or these two incidents, they come from two separate sources. And later on, after Moses, an editor put the two stories together from two separate sources, because this is a clear contradiction. So without the Quran, without what Yusuf says, what the Muslims say, the Bible itself is very clear that this is not the preserved revelation from God, because it contains contradictions.
So, according to your understanding.
Can you explain it a different way?
Well, I mean, you're a nice man. You call me.
Can you explain it a different way?
You see?
Nice man, bad man, can you explain it?
But you see?
Can you explain it?
That because God revealed himself to Moses as the name
Jehovah. And he said, I never gave this name, I never revealed myself with this name to Abraham, Isaac, and Jacob. But when you go back to Genesis, Abraham, according to Genesis, he used the name Jehovah. He knew the name Jehovah.
With due respect, I think the next time I will dive into.
No problem.
But this thing, you see, what you just said.
Yeah.
It doesn't change anything. I've said it from the beginning.
Yeah.
The fact that you don't understand Trinity.
Explain it to me. No, explain this point.
The fact I asked you many simple questions.
You can change the subject if you want,
Paddy. I haven't changed the subject, but I said to you the
answer
next time.
Answer this point.
With due respect, this one.
Okay.
You'll come back to it. Yeah, I'll come.
Okay, no problem. No problem.
But the question I asked.
But for me, it's clear. That's a clear contradiction.
If I show you the Quran, contradictions in the Quran.
Yeah,
I think we next time we talk about.
Uh-huh. Okay, see, no problem.
The beginning of our conversation, I think I respect the fact that we're able to have a very
polite, reasonable.
I'm not the type of guy like to cast this down. Our world is changing.
No, I appreciate it.
We have to talk intellectually, you know, the fact that we might have
we disagree completely, but we can be polite.
At the end of the day, if you don't understand what the gospel means, my humble submission to you, go and do deep investigation, because you see, Quran mentioned a very important word, the Injil, which is the good news. But the good news.
But the Injil was given to Jesus, not the 27 books.
Are you saying when Jesus was walking, he was holding a book, was given to Jesus, holding a book that he was preaching from? Is that what you're saying?
I'm telling you that Jesus, his message is very clear. And when the Quran says Injil, it says, wa'ataynahul Injil. We gave him the Injil.
So if I want to understand. Are you saying Jesus, when he was he was holding a book and preaching? Is that what you're saying?
Let me come to it. Paddy, let me come
you
to
see,
it.
You are very, the way you are saying it, you see, he's giving a book. Uh-huh. Jesus is a revelation. He's
no,
a gospel,
he was
friend.
Given a revelation.
He's a gospel. Don't die rejecting the gospel, because otherwise, as a good man like you, it will be the biggest mistake you've ever made in your life.
You can come with the emotional talk all
it's
you want.
It's not emotional talk. It's not emotional. It's biblical.
The Quran.
It's not emotional.
The final revelation sent down upon the Prophet Muhammad. Are you changing the subject?
I'm not changing the topic.
I think you are.
The war took place, just a few weeks ago, 200 Muslims. I've had encounter with the Lord Jesus Christ.
Okay. Anyway.
No.
Listen.
Just a few weeks ago. Go and check it.
Paddy.
And they are coming home.
Paddy. Let's have a conversation. Let's not go to preacher mode.
No, it's not preacher mode.
Okay. You know, chapter 3, verse 3, you quoted. Let's look at it. Chapter 3, verse 3, you quoted.
Oh,
you quoted a verse.
Yes,
I think, because not only yourself, I understand, obviously, you didn't just read it, you heard it from someone else, you accepted it.
No,
you read it as well.
I've read it,
but I don't think you came across this idea yourself. Possibly you did.
No, I've read it.
Okay.
I read the Quran.
No problem. But I'm saying other people, they use this verse as an evidence from a Christian, Jewish, Hebrew, Israelite perspective. But I would say they haven't understood the verse, and I'm going to tell you why. Okay. So chapter 3, ayat number 3. Nazala alaykul kitab bilhaq.
mission.
So, we have sent down upon you, or sorry, he has sent Allah, because it mentions first, Allahu la ilaha illa huwa al-hayy al-qayyum. Allah, none has the right to be worshipped but him. Al-hayy. Al-hayy is the all-living, al-qayyum, the self-subsisting. He has sent down upon you the book. Here, the book here is referring to the Quran sent down upon the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Yeah. Whether you accept it or not, but it's
no,
saying,
I mean, confirm.
Yes.
It's not me saying, the Quran saying.
Let me finish.
Yeah.
Bil haq, in truth. Musaddiqan lima bayn yaday. Confirming that which you have with you between your hands. And then it says, wa anzala tawrata wal injil. And we have sent down the Torah and the Injil. So, when the Muslims talk about, or when the Quran talks about the Torah and it talks about the Injil, it's talking about what was sent down to Moses and what was sent down to Jesus. It's not talking about what the Christians or the Jews,
so
they wrote after.
What was sent down to Jesus?
The Injil was sent down to him, but not the 27 books.
So, I mean, yeah. If I understood what you just said.
Yes.
So, I mean, are you saying...
Do you understand? This is not affirming the 27 books of the Bible.
No, I mean,
do you
see,
understand
we
that?
Understand do you the scriptures. We understand the position of the scriptures.
Just yes
but
or
what
no.
What you just said.
Do you understand when it says... وَأَنْزَلَ التَّوْرَاةُ وَالْإِنْجِيلُ and he sent down the Torah and the Injil. It's talking about something which was sent down. It's not talking about 27 books of the New Testament written after Jesus.
I just want to follow your argument.
Yes.
That's what I want to follow.
Yes or no?
So are you saying
yes.
From what you just explained, Quran
from my own.
And
explanation? No, Listen. Yeah. Explanation is something else.
Yeah.
I'm simply telling you what is written.
Okay.
And he sent down the Torah and the Injil, min qabl, from before, hudan linnas, a guidance for mankind, wa anzal al furqan, and we have sent down the criteria being the Quran. Inna alladhina kafuru bi ayatillah lahum adhabun shadid. Whoever disbelieves in the verses or the signs of Allah, then for him is a painful punishment. My point is, this verse is talking about what Allah sent down to Moses and what Allah sent down to Jesus. It's not talking about after Jesus was taken up, anonymous unknown authors or a person called Paul wrote down and said, this is the gospel.
I know every Muslim I've ever spoke to.
Yeah.
All my good friends,
every
Muslim from scholar, imam, a layman, they all have problem with Paul.
No,
so
no, Paul is separate.
When you bring
no,
Paul,
no, my point
you're
is,
opening a different
line. No, Paul is a separate issue. But the point is,
Muslim have issue with Paul.
No.
I
mentioned Paul
okay.
because 13 books are attributed to him.
But
my point
okay.
is, the Quran is talking about what was sent down. It's not talking about 27 books written after Jesus.
So are you
yes.
from the Quran
yes.
position?
Yes.
When Jesus was preaching, he was holding a book
in his hand. And we gave... Daniel Kitab, and I was given a book. Yes,
so,
he had a book.
So Jesus,
he had a revelation, not 27
Jesus
books.
Jesus has a book in his hand.
Yes.
Thank you very much. Nice conversation. Have a good day.
Okay, Paddy.